Hey, it's Chris BBTV, and we're joined by Jimmy the Fist First, current Central Area Lightweight Champion, who fights tomorrow. And Jimmy, I mean, you've just finished the weigh-in. You come back there, so you've got a cup of tea in your hand, and you're fighting tomorrow. So thanks for joining us so close to the fight. It's another defence of your Central Area title.
Absolutely, Chris. No, pleasure to be on, and no, thanks for having us. And yeah, I weighed in probably about 2.5 hours ago, yeah, to the dot. So, but I do the weight well, you know, I do it healthily, and you know, just refueling up now, nice and calm, nice and chilled, and ready to do the job tomorrow, mate. Yeah,
you come in what you expected, and was it all okay? You've had time to prepare for this fight. You didn't so much on your last one, but you know, do you have a set way of making the weight, and is it getting easier every time you do it?
Well, it's definitely getting easier every time I do it now, getting the body used to doing it. I don't have a nutritionist on board, can't currently afford one. I've got some lovely sponsors, great people, but I don't have a nutritionist on board, something that may look to in the future. But I just do it. I don't blow up in between fights. I'm only probably 3/4 of a stone walking around at. And then I only have to diet. You know, I could probably do super feather, but I'm 42 years of age in middle of March, in fact, 3 days after the fight. So, you know, there's no point in trying to kill myself making weights. And I do it relatively comfortable. I'm not a massive lightweight, but I'm not a small lightweight. I know I can carry power. And yeah, I just do it healthily. Just bring my carbs down slightly. And just, I'm always eating quite well, so I don't blow up, like I said. Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's been great to see the journey, Jimmy. I was saying that to you. You know, from what year, was it? Two? What year did you turn pro? Doesn't seem long ago.
It was 2017. Yeah. I turned pro. So to say we've had, this is my 15th fight. To say we've, you know, this is coming up 6 years, about 5.5 years as a pro. We've had 2 years out because of COVID. Not bad. You know, Chris Haston's kept me busy and, you know, got the title. I've got an hard fight tomorrow night. But, you know, fully expect and, you know, to retain it. You know, but I'm expecting a very hard fight. You know, my opponent, Josh Padley, is sharp. And, you know, he's coming into my backyard try to take my belt, but it's not happening.
Yeah, it's a home fight as well in Bradford, in your hometown. Josh Padley, yeah, he's unbeaten in 9. You're unbeaten in 14. Like you say, this is your 15th fight. I remember I met Josh last year. I think I went up to the gym. I remember doing an interview with him when I seen his name pop up for this fight. I thought, oh, yeah, you know, I know both of these lads. Yeah, so it's always interesting that it strikes me as a lad with a lot of ambition, you know, dreams of himself becoming a champion. You know, this fight sort of might have gone under the radar a bit, but this could be a small old classic. It's a Yorkshire derby. You know, it's got all the makings of a really good fight. How are you looking at it from that side of things, the derby side, you know, young up and comer again, you know, wanting to, you're putting it on the line again?
Absolutely. You know, it could be an absolute classic. Like me and Brian Phillips had an absolute barnstormer of a 10 rounder. Me and Brian, sorry, are you still there? Sorry, yeah. Me and Brian, barnstormer of a 10-rounder. Me and Justin Newell had a cracker for the central area as well. And yeah, it's a Yorkshire derby. You know, he's got big aspirations. He's sharp. You know, he's very good. He's a talented boxer. So it's gonna make for an absolute cracker. You know, so but he's not been past 6. You know, so let's see how. See how good a swimmer he is when I drag him into deep waters, you know. So, but yeah, it's gonna be great, and I'm looking forward to it. It's gonna be a packed out, intimate little, you know, intimate arena there, not arena, but the hotel. You know, it's gonna be, it's gonna be noisy. It's gonna be hot, and expecting fireworks.
Yeah, it should be a great atmosphere. You said they're drag him into deep waters. Do you feel you've got the edging experience then, and that's what will be the key when you say that? As a bottle, you know, do you look at it as a, you know, I mean, in your last fight, Corey Gibbs, you'd drawn him into a fight and the tactically you got it right like that. How do you feel tactically you might have to go about this one without giving too much away? What type of a fight do you expect from Josh?
I don't know. I think he might come I think he might come and go for it for the first, you know, early on. He might box and move. I'm not exactly too sure, but I know that I've got an absolute engine and, you know, I'm very tough. So I just keep coming at you. So let's just see how fit he is and how, you know, how hungry he really is. And just when it comes to them trenches, when it comes to when it gets really hard into the seventh, eighth, you know, ninth, tenth rounds, you know, how is he going to stand with it? But listen, I'm expecting him to be able to. I'm not underestimating him one little bit. I'm expecting him to be the fittest, the strongest he's ever been and the sharpest. So got to be on high alert. And yeah, I'll be, you know, it's going to be a cracker, but I'm ready. Yeah.
It is going to be a good fight. Implore anyone to tune in if they can. Is it being filmed, the fight, Jimmy?
I don't think so. It's a new promoter, Darren Burley. I don't think he's got anyone doing on YouTube. There might be just a few people in the crowd. I've got a few pals that do a bit of videoing, but there's no one that I know of filming it. Yeah.
What a shame, because I think this is going to be a great fight, definitely. I mean, talking to Yorkshire derbies, you're used to them. You fight, what you mentioned about Justin Newell when you won the title. I mean, you know, what a fight for you that was. You know, really, take us back to that, you know, winning the title and becoming champion. I mean, you know, you didn't turn pro till you was, 36? You didn't start boxing till you was 29. You know, you've been an inspiration. We spoke about that in the past. I've seen your other interviews. You know, I remember you saying you went to a boxing gym, someone hit you, and you realised you had this fight in you, and you thought, I'm going to go and give it a go. Age has been no barrier for you. So, fair play.
Yeah, that's right. It's, we had an absolute barnstorm, and me and Justin, and it was very emotional. I knew Justin really well. You know, we kind of arranged the fight ourselves in a coffee shop in Good Karma in Brighouse. And, you know, the whole lead up to it, I wasn't actually well the night before. My sinuses were all blocked. And I thought, oh God. But then when I got there, you know, I had that beast within, and I dragged it out of the depths of my soul. And, you know, it were an emotional night. Made sure Justin was okay, because it was a heck of a punch. And, you know, I know that I've got power. So, but yeah, it was, I made sure he was okay before there was any celebrations. But, very emotional winning that title, and I just feel like I'm getting better and better. Like I say, I'm 42 in a few days, but age is just a number, and as long as, you know, I don't get any bad injuries or anything like that, I'll keep going until my trainers, who are great guys, Mark Early, Chris Aston, when they say to me, look, you're slowing down, and or, you know, start taking bad beatings, then we'll look at it. But right now things are going good, so we'll keep going.
I said to you, I remember you fight the Hilton, I think it was your second pro fight, something like Jamie Quinn, I think it was. I remember you said, we asked you after, what's your secret? And you said, red wine. So are you still on the red wine, Jim? What is the secret to this?
I have a little tipple every now and then, not too much. My dad was an organic grower, he grew veg. So I've had, you know, good, I've been blessed with that. My dad, who was growing a lot of our organic veg. So I had that from an early age. And I've always been doing sport, you know, before I got into boxing. And I was just an all-rounder, really. I don't know, it's just a big heart, you know. I've just got that heart and the grit. And when I walked into a boxing gym and got hit, it was like do or die. And, you know, you either crumble and think, sod this, I'll go back to playing snooker or whatever. But I want to better myself here. Let me give him a black eye, never mind me, you know, and start improving and being able to miss punches and things, slip and slide. So, yeah, just the mentality is you can do it, you know. And I was always quite fit. The fitness is there as well, so, yeah.
He's decent at snooker.
There you go, mate.
Snooker, he was decent, was he?
Nah, not really, no. I would just use that as an example. No.
Right.
Snooker's hard, isn't it? Yeah, no, very difficult. Yeah.
I mean, in your last fight, Corey Gibbs, we just touched on it there. I mean, I'm sure you was it 16, 17 to 1 underdog going into that? You got a call up late, it was on Sky, big show, and you go and upset the apple cart there. And, you know, Corey was, you know, good fighter. I mean, you you got it right on the night, and you know, you was marked up a bit after that, but you got the win. And you know, what a great win. Take us back to that, Jimmy. You wasn't meant to do that, was you, on the night? Got you in a bit late, and
yeah, that's it. Ten days' notice. Got the we got the call up. We looked at him. We saw he'd had a bit of recent inactivity, and you know, not a massive puncher. So we were like, look, you know, let's go risk. You know, the risk was the reward was well worth the risk. So, but we had a feeling we knew we were gonna do it. There was something in the air. We just like, look, we just knew. So we went down there and dragged him into the trenches, dragged him into them deep waters, and you know, the rest was history. You know, we got the job done, and another brilliant night, and I've made a lot of people, you know, happy for Christmas, because they're, you know, they're like people who I were 8-1 to win outright, and I think I was 16-1 to win on points. So yeah, there were people that were really happy, paid for a lot of people's Christmas. So yeah, delighted about that. Yeah.
Brilliant. Yeah. Well done on that, Jimmy. Yeah. I heard you go away a bit as well, don't you? And sort of like busman's holidays, you know, training abroad. Is it Cuba, Philippines, Mexico? It's interesting now. What do you do there, Jimmy? How's that come about? Is it like a busman's holiday? You go away to do these training camps?
Yeah. Just 1 minute, Chris. I think my battery's going to go low. I might have to swap seats and get my charger on. Is that all right?
No problem. Second. Yeah,
sure. Just gonna have a little move around here. One sec. Just don't want to lose you. Sorry about that. Change of scenery. There we go. Is that all right?
Perfect.
Yeah. Right. Cool, mate. Sorry about that. I love it. I've loved traveling. Like, I went off traveling with six friends when I was five other lads. There were six of us, and we went around Thailand, Vietnam, Cambodia, Australia, Bali. We had like a working visa in Australia, and I just got the bug for it. And now me and my Mrs. Paula, when I go on, you know, I went to Cuba recently in January, and I also thought get the best of both. Love my boxing, love my travel, and because I started boxing late as well, just fully immerse myself in the sport and try and pick up techniques and little things, you know, in different gyms. So yeah, like I said, I was in the Philippines, went out there, did a week, but loads of sparring. They were all southpaws. They all, you know, they were really good kids. I think there was a lad who was ranked second or third in Philippines, and Roald Dan Aldea, a very good boxer. But just walking in them hot, stuffy gyms, which gives you that experience as well. You know, like you can, you know, now, you know, walking a box. I mean, you've been in the Mexico City. I sparred Angelo Napoles, and he was like WBC Youth Intercontinental Champion or International Champion. Met Nacho Bernstein, which was great as well. And then, been to Cuba a couple of times. So I love it. You know, I just love to mix it up and try and learn different things. Yeah.
That's really good, Jim. And obviously Cuba, I mean, it's, you know, renowned for great boxers. That must be a good experience being there. And I mean, do you feel that when you're there, that, you know, boxing's such a big sport, like the national sport?
Oh, Chris, honestly, mate, yeah, the Cubans, the way their intricacy and the footwork, it's just so clever, you know, it's so clever. Like I say, 32-degree heat, you know, you don't hardly have to do a warm-up, you're instantly sweating, and you're sparring different guys all the time, so you're getting different loads of different experiences, yeah. So it's, I went and sparred national champions, went and trained with the Cuban national team, my friend Michael out there as well. Brilliant coach, just brilliant coach, and you're doing something different every single day. So yeah, it's an incredible place, Cuba, Havana. Yeah, definitely. And you know, I'm happy to pass the details on if anybody on here watching wants to go out to Cuba and learn a bit. I'm happy to get in touch with me. I'm happy to pass my contacts over by all means. You know, share the love. No problem.
It's nice of you, Jimmy. Yeah, I'm sure someone might take you up on that. Yeah.
Definitely. Yeah. Yeah, I might even start doing Cuban trips in the future.
Yeah, a little business there.
Yeah, a few Cuban trips, bring a few cigars back.
Are you boxing full time now, Jimmy? Or are you still working?
Yeah, well, I'm boxing full time, but I do a little bit of PT in here and there. Just to a select few. There's some youngsters that I help out and train up. So just that plus my boxing really is my main source of income. Yeah, yeah.
You got Dickie's gym with Mark.
Yeah, Mark, Callum Simpson, Corey O'Regan's, the Yasmina, still yeah. The cracking team. But I also train with my manager and trainer who I've been with from the start, Chris Aston. The whole team gels really well. Mark's got his style, Chris has got his style, and I bring the two together, and it's really good. Yeah, really good.
You got Callum Simpson in that gym, has he? You got young pros around. He's some talent, Callum, isn't he?
Oh, he's a top boy, Callum. Yeah, he's got a heart of gold. He'll do anything for anyone. And one heck of a talent, as is Corey O'Regan. But while you mentioned Callum, yeah, he's been signed by Boxer, by Ben Shalom's. A lot, really. And, yeah, sky's the limit for that lad. He's incredible. When you see some of the stuff that he does in the gym, his hand speed for such a big guy. He's lightning. But it's not just his hands, it's his feet, it's his positioning. He's got power. And I'm part of his corner team. And sky's the limit for that lad, isn't it? It's a big journey, big future ahead for Callum, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I believe so. Yeah, I seen him the other day in Oldham. I said I've got his number, so I'm gonna come up to the gym. So hopefully you'll be there as well. So you wanna come up.
Great, Chris, yeah. Oh, no, he's a great lad, he's Callum, and spars a lot with Lyndon Arthur, Mark Efron. He's done a lot with Sniper Boss, hasn't he? Lerone Richards. Obviously went out to Canada to prepare better beer for Anthony Yard. And, they loved him out there. They loved him.
Well, you say that Callum's got no limit. I was going to ask you, what is your end goal in boxing? Do you put a limit on yourself, Jimmy? Do you think, I'm central area champion, I'm going to, next step is this, next step's that, or do you have an end goal? Do you think that?
Yeah, that's why, I mean, my name got mentioned with, on DAZN yesterday, actually, for Campbell Hatton. I've got the central area title, but then I heard an interview with him saying, oh yeah, maybe a couple more fights, a couple of eight rounders. Let's have the fight now. Campbell Hatton, step up and come and fight a 42-year-old, obviously, and it'll be Josh Padley first. I'm not overlooking Josh Padley tomorrow night. But there's Campbell Hatton. But my aspirations would be to get an English and maybe a British. The British title would be like a world title to me, Chris. And, maybe I'd retire after a British. I'm not putting a limit on age-wise because I'm still defying time and I'm still, I'm still doing great and I'm still improving. But I'm obviously conscious about, sport of boxing is very dangerous as well, As you grow older, the protective layer around your brain does diminish. And, I have to think about, health in the future. But, I'm getting better. I'm improving. My defence is getting better. I'm slipping and sliding and, riding shots better now. And, half of these 25-year-olds don't stand with me. They can't stand with me with the pace. So, see what happens, Chris. But, I've probably overachieved what I originally set out to do, because it was just going to be one fight at a time, and just do it, just turn professional, just so I didn't have any regrets in life, really, Chris.
Yeah.
So, and we are where we are, and that's boxing for you. Anything can happen, isn't it?
Yeah, you're an absolute gentleman, and credit to boxing, and it's the fighting tomorrow. It says a lot about you joining me here on a Zoom, and you've got this fight tomorrow. So, Jimmy, I wish you all the very best, and thanks for it's great to speak to you, gentlemen.
Likewise. You. Yeah.
It's going to be nothing but a great fight tomorrow. You know, you're going to have a right highlight reel of great fights, aren't you? You know, to look back on. So I'm sure this is going to be another one as well.
Exactly. You know, this is, you know, I've had, you know, Corey Gibbs 17-0, Justin Yule 17-0, Brian Phillips were 9-1, now another 9-0 kid. You know, I'm not shying away from, you know, these fights. So when it's all said and done, you know, I can be proud, Carter. Yeah.
Absolutely, mate. Well, again, thanks for joining us. Wish you all the best tomorrow. God bless. And we'll speak again soon, Jim.
Very much, Chris. Take care, mate.